Hello and welcome back to the channel. Tech Ed here with another video for you. So today we're going to be talking about fans, and I'm excited about this one because I have been waiting to get one of these fans for quite some time. I have the Corsair ML120 that I'm using as my CPU fan, and I'm going to be looking down at my notes during most of the video. So if you see me looking down and reading, then don't be alarmed. I'm just looking through my notes. So many of you may or may not know that most computers that you use have a fan of some kind inside. There are a lot of devices that we use that don't have any fans, being smartphones or maybe even a few TVs. And there are plenty of devices that we use that don't require any fans. They are cooled passively. But that machine behind me has quite a few fans inside of it, and those fans are needed to keep the parts inside fairly cool. So I have purchased a new fan for my CPU. It is an ML120 from Corsair. I will be referring to this fan as the ML fan from now on. The fan that I have on my CPU cooler is an Air Balance 120 from Cooler Master, and it is a good fan, but this one, we'll get to it later, but this one is proven to be a little more effective. So I'll be referring to the Cooler Master fan as AB from now on, and let's get right into it. The main issue that I have with my current fan is the noise from the bearing inside the fan. So when I'm playing games, or when I'm video editing, or when I'm rendering that video, the fan that I currently have on my CPU cooler, the bearing kind of clicks. It occasionally clicks, and then it occasionally whines at certain RPM ranges. So I'll try to capture some of that on video. Whether or not you'll be able to hear it, it's all directly associated with the microphone that I use to record that, but I'll try to get some of that video and footage for you so you can hear it. This new fan, this Corsair fan, uses magnetic levitation, which is what ML stands for, and the idea behind that is the bearing that the fan spins, the hub of the housing that it spins on, doesn't have any traditional bearings. There's no connecting points, there's nothing there to really contact other than the electromagnets that are inside of it. So in testing, I can say that is true. There are no traditional bearings, there is no bearing noise, no whine, and that was really exciting for me when I started rendering things using this new fan. It has a power usage of 0.225 amps. It has a speed range of 400 to 2400 RPM. Its dimensions are 120 millimeters by 25 millimeters. Sound noise, it ranges between 16 and 37 decibels. It uses a 4-pin PWM connector, and the PWM standard gives you a little more control over what RPM ranges you're running at. It's optimized for both airflow and static pressure. Airflow meaning, say you put it on the front of your case and you want to just suck in as much air as you want, as you can, through that case. Static pressure is, say, attaching that fan to a radiator. You need more optimized static pressure in order to push more air through that radiator. And each fan design will give you one or the other, depending, but they've designed this one to give you sort of a combination of both. We'll go through the performance of this to show you just how well it does perform. I can say that the blade design on this fan, the blades make a little more noise. So you hear more wind noise out of this fan than you do on the Air Balance fan that I have. But again, I'm not hearing any whine, I'm not hearing any clicks, and those really bother me through the side panel of my case. A little bit of wind noise, I'm fine with that. that's a more consistent noise, but that high pitch whining, it drives me nuts. It drives me insane. And that's why I decided to switch to a new fan. This fan also doesn't have, I opted for the Pro version. It also doesn't have any RGB LEDs. There are no lights on this fan, and I'm okay with that. The lack of the extra cable to run those LEDs is worth it, in my opinion. RGB is nice, but once you start adding on or doubling the amount of wires that you have to use on your fans, becomes kind of annoying. And so in my opinion, the less that I have of that, the better. My case behind me has a good amount of RGB LEDs on it, so I don't really need to use RGBs on my fans. I think it's kind of dumb. So let's talk about performance. Because the ML120 fan has been out for a few years now, I'm not going to do any noise or airflow testing. If you want to find that information, you can find that online. Any other YouTube video, just Google it, YouTube it. You can find that if you really want to look for it. So what I will show you is how this fan performs versus the air balance fan. In a certain scenario, I have an i7-8700K. I have overclocked it to 4.7 gigahertz on all cores, all six cores. What I did was I took a 10-minute video that I had already created, and I used Adobe Media Encoder to convert the video from H.264 1080p to H.264 4K. You don't really need to know what that means. All you need to know is that it puts a lot of stress on the CPU. So it takes that CPU, and that CPU is working hard at about 100% usage for the entire 10 minutes that it takes to render that video. I used CPU ID to record the fan speed and CPU temperatures. And as you can see, the Air Balance 120 hit a maximum fan speed of 2085 RPM with a maximum CPU temperature of 86 degrees Celsius. The ML fan, the one that I purchased, hit a maximum speed of 2147 with a maximum CPU temperature of 84 degrees Celsius. And here is a quick 10 second clip of both of those fans, just so you can hear what they sound like. So, in conclusion, what do we have? We have a fan that performs really well, considering the task that was set before it. It looks great. It's very sturdy, as you can see in this quick video. The Air Balance fan has a good amount of give to it, but the Corsair ML fan is solid construction. You can tell it's well built. If you want to purchase this fan for yourself, I will link it down in the video description, but I am extremely happy with this fan. I plan on, in the future, replacing the rest of the fans in my case with these. I think it's a great option for both airflow and static pressure. It performed excellent in the against the radiator of my CPU cooler, and I love the way they look. I love the blackout aesthetic that it has on it, and so I give this one a thumbs up. So if you're Corsair listening or watching this video, send me some more things. I'd love to do some more reviews of your products. I really enjoy working with Corsair products. Everything is built well, and they perform well for the price that they are charging. So again, great fan. And like and subscribe for more content. I'll be posting more videos in the near future. And thanks for joining. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.